Alright guys, so a couple weeks ago, I got myself the 2007 Volkswagen Golf, and the car came with no spoiler. So today, we're going to design our own custom spoiler with minimum tool, just like our drawing and a 3D printer. And we don't even have a garage, so we're going to put it outside in the snow. Let's go. So here's my girlfriend trying to help me up with the camera.
Say something.
Hello.
What's that? No, I'm not filming. Just say something.
Panda.
Alright, let's get to our drawing board. Here, I usually like to draw on my tablet. Now, I look up a couple spoiler design on online. And the stock spoiler is a little bit small for me. I think it could be a bit bigger. Now for this design, I like the idea, but I feel like it doesn't blend very well with the car. But it could be something pretty cool, like some sort of time attack golf. And also this one I think I'd say I like it the most. It's just the V cut at the middle. I find it's a little strange, like for the overall shape of the car. So that's why we're gonna design our own. We're gonna make something that we like. So here you can see me also trying to explore some other concept. So there's also a concept that I really like, which is trying to not only make a spoiler, but also extend the body panel of the car. Now there's an example that I was based off, which is the 2019 Chevrolet Sonic. They have these extended roof spoiler, but also kind of extend the side panel of the car. I find it looks pretty cool and sporty, so. But finally, we decide to go for this design right here. It looks sporty enough, not too something too crazy, and fit the overall shape of the car. So we're gonna give it a try. All right, so we got the drawing done. We know what we want. And now let's jump to 3D modeling, which is the very crucial part, because in order to 3D print it, we need a digital model, right? I don't have a 3D scanner, so I cannot scan my car. So what I did was I basically asked around for a 3D scan file of the Golf 4, and I'm lucky enough to find a guy who willing to sell me his scan data. So I got it, and let's jump right into it. So this process is a little boring, I would say, trying to align the design with the 3D scan that we have. Just so when we make it in real life, it would fit perfectly. And usually these scans, they are not very symmetrical on both sides, so we'll need to take some measurement on the real car and like play around with it. All right guys, so we have a problem. The 3D printer that we're planning to use is preserved for engineering team. I'm in an engineering team, but this is kind of like a personal project. So the only time that I can access the printer without disturbing other people, which is nighttime, like past 10 p.m. So we're gonna stay at school pretty late, from 10 p.m. to probably 2 a.m., something like that, to get the print done. Let's go. We finished this print pretty late at night. I think it was 1 a.m. But me and the boy, we were so excited, so we tried to put it on like in the middle of the night.
Right? Yeah, there's a gap. There's a gap. You can see the gap. Uh-huh. And the look.
Like, push down the middle.
Move that.
Oh, where?
It's gonna fall. It's gonna fall. Save this. You think it's safe when I take off the paint?
So the next day, I wanted to put it back on to take some more pictures. And also put it more like properly, because yesterday it was a little rushed. Here you're gonna see me trying to put on the spoiler outside in the snow, because I simply don't have a garage, and this is my kind of like my outdoor parking spot. So I mean, there's no one pass through this during daytime, so I don't see why not. It's big enough for us. It's a little cold, but we are well prepared. So I think my neighbor caught me doing this spoiler thing when he came back home on his Audi. But I mean, we don't have a choice, so we gotta do what we have to do. So here's the transformation. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with the result, because like you see the 3D print line up perfectly with the body panel line, kind of like the an OEM design from Volkswagen, and not like an aftermarket Timu like build, you know. So I'm happy with that. Now make sure, if you like my journey, click like and subscribe, because I'm on a build, like a custom body kit for my Golf, like from the bumper to the fender. And basically, we're gonna make a very unique Volkswagen Golf MK4. So make sure to subscribe and follow my journey. And we'll see you around. See you next time.